Welcome back to another episode of What Did the Patient Say with Drs. Dana and Lauren Brindisi, sisters and owners of Carolina Functional Neurology Center. We are bringing you inside information from real conversations we have with patients on a daily basis. We get asked the same questions and want to spread the truth on health and healing because we believe everyone deserves to know the answers. Hi, everybody. Welcome back to another episode of What Did the Patient Say with myself, Dr. Dana, and my sister and co-owner of Carolina Functional Neurology Center, Dr. Lauren. Today, we're going to be talking to you guys about autoimmune conditions, kind of what they are, what are some common ones that we see, you know, what that means for patients that have them, those kinds of things. And then we'll be interested in what questions you guys have, and we'll do a little bit more of a deep dive maybe next year, since it's almost the new year, on these types of conditions and kind of what that means when you have them. So Dr. Lauren, kind of start us off here and give us just an intro, like what is autoimmune disease, or maybe also we could talk about what autoimmunity is without having a full-blown disorder. I think that's something that, you know, we see functionally quite a bit that people maybe don't even recognize. Take it away.
Okay. So in a nutshell, when you're talking about autoimmunity, you're looking at the immune system, which is attacking self. So that really means that with autoimmunities, there can be all types of conditions that fall under this category in which your immune system, which it should attack foreign invaders like viruses and bacteria, it does the same thing, but it decides to do it for a tissue of your own, whether that's your nervous system, your thyroid, parts of your gut, your skin, the list goes on and on. There are some common conditions out there that, you know, we see a lot of patients get tested for before they come in, because there is a lot of overlap with some of the conditions that we treat that can create a whole variety of symptoms for people that may be related to something more autoimmune in nature. So I would say some of the common ones that we see are MS, which attacks the myelin sheath, that the coating around the nervous system, around neurons. So you have your neuron, and then it's bathed in this coating that helps the electrical activity actually send a signal. We see Sjogren's, which a lot of our dysautonomia patients may have, and that's affecting glands. So we see dry eyes and dry mouth are a pretty common thing.
Exocrine glands specifically.
Yeah. We'll see patients with Crohn's and other types of, you know, autoimmunity to the digestive tract. Celiac disease is a really interesting one, because it's actually an allergy that's creating an autoimmunity, which is really unique. What else do we see, Dana?
Hashimoto's, Graves' disease. You know, we've talked about, you know, there's different types of autoimmunity to things like the nervous system. You know, there's tests out there where you can test not only for things like antibodies to myelin, like you're talking about with MS, but, you know, do you have antibodies to your cerebellum? Do you have antibodies to, you know, different parts of your nervous system and things like that? So, you know, we see that quite a bit. You know, there's all this talk now about, you know, is POTS, or do some POTS patients have autoimmune POTS where they're making antibodies to certain receptors, and things like that. I think you covered the big ones. I mean, lupus is a big one, but, you know, we don't necessarily see that quite as often. People aren't necessarily coming in to us for treatment for lupus. So,
What's interesting about autoimmunity is the basis is, of course, your immune system. So what's tricky for people is once they develop an autoimmunity, unfortunately, that can increase their susceptibility to another autoimmunity. Yeah. So it can be a little bit of a vicious cycle. And I think what Dr. Dana and I want to kind of delve into hopefully next year are some of the things that we do and some of the more progressive viewpoints on how we actually address autoimmunity, and things that can be done from a more, you know, from a lifestyle basis of understanding that this is a chronic illness, but your fate isn't just to, you know, be riddled with autoimmunity. And I can speak and attest to that myself. I've had psoriasis since I was 9 years old, And I used to be about 90% covered in it. I had a really, really bad case of it. Anytime I got a sore throat or a little bit sick, exposed to something, I mean, my skin would just break out all over the place. So I am pretty passionate about treating these things and helping patients understand that there's a lot you can do that can complement. You know, some people do respond well to medications and other immunosuppressants and steroids, but they're just not long-term. They come with a lot of side effects. So there are tons of other things that can be done on top of that to do this more naturally and be able to really understand what you're dealing with and the things that you can do on a regular basis to give your immune system, you know, the best health possible. So that hopefully the way I describe to patients, I go, we just need to tell your immune system to chill out. It just wants to attack everything. So when we can regulate that from some more natural perspectives, that can really, really help those classical waxing and waning of symptoms that we see with autoimmunity. And I am living proof of that.
Yeah. And I think, you know, the important thing that maybe people don't quite understand, I mean, the immune system is so complex, right? And so I think to understand that your immune system kind of runs on a spectrum, right? So like on one side of things, we've got autoimmunity. On the far other side of things, we have immune suppressive disorders, right? Where people don't actually even produce enough antibodies to fight anything, right? And then this side is we're producing antibodies to everything. You know, and the interesting thing about when you take medication for something like autoimmune disease is it's basically taking you from here and it's pushing you towards this end of the spectrum. So what happens, right? You end up more susceptible to, you know, all the other bugs and things that are crawling around our world, right? Bacteria, viruses, like all of that. You become more susceptible to being sick, basically, right? They're suppressing the immune system so that you don't attack your own body tissue as easily as you were before, which is a great solution. And I think to make a point of, it doesn't have to be one or the other, right? Like we see people that are on immunosuppressive drugs while we help them make nutritional changes, lifestyle changes, give them supplementation that's actually supporting your immune system, you know. And for those of you that like all the science and stuff like that, there's multiple systems that play a role in that, right? And things that we consume aren't necessarily what we would call immune neutral, right? They're not necessarily balancing that teeter-totter of autoimmunity versus immune suppression. And so depending on what you're dealing with, that's what we take a look at and say, okay, we want to maybe drive this system closer to midline so that you're not producing enough antibodies without driving it past that point. So now you're susceptible to other disease, right? It's a very tricky balance, and it's definitely something that, you know, like you said, Dr. Lauren, the ebbs and flows, right? It's something that you constantly have to manage. So it's not like, you know, we see people and we're like, here, take this supplement for the rest of your life, and this is the dose that you have to be on, and you know, you'll be good, right? It's something that needs to be managed. It's a chronic disorder. There is no cure, regardless of the autoimmune condition that you have, right? That's a blanket statement kind of across the board. But it is very well managed in a lot of cases through some of this stuff. And then there are things that trigger it. Like Dr. Lauren said, you know, hers gets triggered when she gets sick. Now, that doesn't happen as often anymore because she's modulated that immune response so that every time she gets sick, she doesn't end up in a huge flare. But, you know, she may increase her dosages of some supplements when she's around somebody that's sick or she feels like she's a little bit under the weather. And she's learned over the years, like those are the things that she has to do to help herself and make sure that she doesn't end up in such a flare like she used to. And that's pretty much across the board for all of these conditions. So, you know, the other thing, do you have any other things to kind of comment? I had another comment of just like autoimmunity in general too.
Yeah, I just think it's a constant learning process. And the more, what really, I mean, even drove me to do what I do is really this, it really becoming empowered and educated on what I was dealing with. For the longest time, I had no idea that psoriasis was even an autoimmune condition. Everyone just, it's a skin problem. Okay. Like, what does that mean? You know? So when I started really understanding what autoimmunity is and the things that I can do, that really helped me even just mentally, The emotional toll that just chronic illness in general can take on people, to better understand, and then I feel like I have more control over it. And then I start to actually use that as almost a guide for, you know, checking in with how my body in general and how my health is. If things flare up a little bit, you know, can I pinpoint like why? And this year was a big one where I started really thinking about this time of year. It got really dry really fast in North Carolina. It got really cold. And I go, man, thinking about it every year, this time of year, as it gets like this, I have some type of flare up. But what I realized is this year compared to last year, I'm doing a lot better than I was. So those things and the way you look at it and the way you frame that, I think is huge. You don't have to be a victim to your chronic illness. It's something that now I kind of almost use as like a blessing in disguise. If my skin isn't doing great, I'm like, okay, it probably means inside is struggling.
Things are not going well in there.
So let me mostly cook. Yeah. Yeah. And I know, and for me with the, you know, with the weather part, it really is, you know, I've been doing a lot topically, but I'm also, you know, making sure I'm drinking more water than I usually am, getting, you know, really good night's sleeps, managing my stress. I'm just being extra, extra cognizant of all of the other things I normally do, my diet.
It's like things everybody should be cognitive of and everybody should be paying attention to, right? It's just some people are going to be more susceptible to something if they don't sleep well, or if they're under a lot of stress and they're not managing it correctly, or they go on a binge and they've been eating fast food for the last 5 days. You know, like some people can handle that to some capacity or some degree, you know, but autoimmune or no autoimmune, all of these things that we're talking about are diet and lifestyle things that most people, you know that they should be doing and should be paying attention to. But sometimes I think it's just human nature where if it's not quite throwing us into a tailspin, we kind of like let it go until it's something that we have to kind of check ourselves on, which unfortunately is usually some sort of symptom or, you know, you don't feel well, but at that point it's already gone on too long. So it's better to kind of address it. And like you said, where, you know, you manage this, you know, all the time at this point, and you know what you need to do and you know how to handle it. And it's just something that you maybe have to check yourself a little bit more in certain scenarios than somebody else. And the scenarios are, I think, you know, some are general to autoimmune conditions, but they can also be very specific to the individual themselves.
Yeah. And that's why I realized the thing I'm thinking about this year is, okay, I know you can't predict the weather, but I think I'll be a lot more cognizant of the weather changing and try to get ahead of it next year. Yeah. So instead of waiting till I'm like, my skin definitely, things feel dry, it's cold out, like as that weather starts to turn, I'm going to ramp up all of the things, you know, the supplements, and make sure I'm being, you know, really cognizant of my diet and all of these things that can be useful, and see if I can get ahead of it without having any type of flare.
Yeah. And I think that's something that people have to learn over time. It doesn't just happen.
No. You know? So this has been a journey. I mean, really changing my diet and all of that started, I was about 19 and I got swine flu and everything went crazy for months and months and months after that. And that was the moment. And you were in school, and actually Dana started really helping me and educating me on what I was dealing with, and helped me a lot in terms of starting to figure out what I needed to do to take control of this. So it's been a long time that I've been on this journey. And that's, again, why I'm really passionate about it, because you can take control of these things and you have a lot more control over your fate and situation around your chronic illness than I think a lot of us are led to believe.
I would agree with that. I wanted to make, you know, kind of one more, you know, comment and kind of topic for us to address is the world of what we call in functional medicine autoimmunity, where, you know, you might be producing antibodies, you might have a positive ANA, you know, there are things happening in the immune system on this side of the spectrum without having a full-blown disorder. And the best way I can describe it is in reference to your thyroid. We see a lot of patients that produce antibodies to their thyroid, but their thyroid panel, so if you guys know anything about thyroid, TSH, T4, T3, right, your thyroid hormones themselves are actually perfectly fine. this is a gray area that a lot of people live in, not only for thyroid, but autoimmune realm in general, where the immune system is being pushed in this direction. But what most people don't know is in order to be diagnosed with an autoimmune disease, usually your body has destroyed almost 60% of the tissue that it's attacking before you would ever actually get a diagnosis of autoimmune disease. So if we're talking in reference to your thyroid, 60% of your thyroid has been destroyed, right, by the antibodies that are produced before it would show up on your lab work that you have Hashimoto's hypothyroid or hyperthyroid. You could have Graves' disease, right? That's a lot of body tissue. That's a lot of destruction. And you know, in functional medicine, you know, whether you're seeing us or you're seeing any other integrative MD or somebody, anybody that specializes in kind of the functional world of healthcare, really looks at very seriously, because what we want to do is say, like, we understand that this underlying process has already started. Mm-hmm. Now, before we develop full-blown psoriasis, for example, how do we manage the immune system like we're talking about right now before it ends up in a disease? And that's something that, again, we catch a lot and we see. I mean, Lauren, I don't know how many patients that are like, I have a positive AMA, but I tested negative for Sjogren's. I tested negative for lupus. I tested negative for RA, right? And everyone's like, I don't know. And I'm like, I don't love that, right? And what we do is say, okay, your immune system is brewing in a way that we don't want it to. And we need to make sure we manage that, because at that point, we don't know what tissue it wants to address. Right. So I think that's really important for people to understand. And, you know, there's a lot of information out there about this topic. Right. And it's different than saying you have an autoimmune disease. And I think that's really important for people to know that are listening, that are struggling with things where they're like, I swear my thyroid is struggling. Right. And then you go to the doctor, they run a TSH and a T4 and they're like, your thyroid's fine. But if you didn't check those antibodies, TPO antibodies, thyroglobulin antibodies, right? You're missing piece of that puzzle that could really be why you are struggling with these symptoms without having the disease markers on lab work. So I think that's really super important. And it's very important to be your own advocate when you're in the healthcare world, because you got to equip yourself with the knowledge to be able to say, like, hey, I know that this isn't saying that it's normal, but there's something definitely wrong. And I want to get some antibodies checked. I have a family history of autoimmune disease. My mom has lupus. My sister has MS. My grandma had RA, right? Like if you're that person and then you're struggling with things that seem to be, this is kind of classic picture that I see painted in patients that struggle with this, is usually there's family history, but not always. And then it's just these random symptoms where they're like, I don't know. I've had every test under the sun. Everybody tells me everything's fine and I'm normal, but I don't feel fine. And I've got this thing going on. They all seem, you know, different to me. That is like the Picasso of autoimmune paintings. I mean, it is real. My alerts are going up. We need to look at some antibody testing and see what the heck is going on with your immune system.
Yeah. And it comes and goes. Well, it was really bad at this time. And then all of a sudden it seemed like everything seemed to get better. And then I got really stressed out and everything got worse again, and it comes and goes.
And I feel like these patients are always like, I feel like I'm crazy and I don't know what's going on. Or, you know, I'm told it's my anxiety, as we talk about all the time. And I don't know why that's not what's happening, you know, those kinds of things. So I think that's super important, and that can go for anything. You know, we talked about it in reference to thyroid, but I mean, if you feel that, you know, in your gut, or you feel like you're having neurological symptoms or things like that, and they're kind of, like you said, Lauren, kind of waxing and waning. But then there's like, they're just all weird and random. They might not always be the same, mm-hmm. you know?
Yeah.
To me, that is immune spectrum needs more investigation.
Yeah. Okay. Well, if you guys have any questions specifically about autoimmunities, any specific conditions, any information more about autoimmunity versus autoimmune disease, Please let us know, comment, share, like this. We're going to hopefully delve a little bit deeper into this coming up next year, 2022.
Yeah, we're wrapping up for the year of 2021. So if there are definitely things, you know, if you guys want more detail on things, again, we always say you guys are driving these videos. So if let us know what you guys want. If you have specific questions, keep us posted.
Yep. All right. Enjoy your day. Bye.